Greetings, salutations to Safe to Serve International and first-time viewers. Welcome to this midday power surge. I'm your host, Andrew Henriquez. Now, today is another startling, important presentation as it relates to practical and spiritual preparation for these last days. The signs of the times are ominous. These are the fulfillment of end time Bible prophecies. And today I want to focus on this particular news which is trending. And this is in regards to the total eclipse of the sun, which will transpire on April 8th, 2024, from daylight to darkness for about 4 minutes. That moon will cover the sun. Take a look.
A cosmic event for the ages, shaping up to be the hottest ticket in town. On April 8th, a total eclipse of the sun will plunge millions of viewers from daylight into darkness for more than four captivating minutes in parts of the country. And excitement is already building as so-called eclipse tourists rush to book travel to be in its path.
So while many people are excited about this coming celestial sign, celestial glory, they're now telling us that this coming eclipse of the sun on April 8th, it is going to bring food shortages. It's going to bring fuel shortages. It's going to bring internet outage, cell phone disruption. It's going to lead into a state of emergency. Yes. And that's why this presentation is so important. As a result, let me deal with the fanfare and get to the seriousness of this issue here. They're talking about hotel rooms are all booked out. The path that the sun is going to travel as the moon eclipses it totally. Airline tickets, extremely expensive. Here it is. Mentally consume this.
I'm excited about an insurgence of tourism.
Hotel rates are spiking throughout the eclipse's path.
Fuck.
Some resorts offering luxury cosmic-themed stays for thousands of dollars. Others will get the chance to catch the eclipse from the sky. Delta offering a flight from Austin to Detroit to give onlookers an out-of-this-world view.
And guys, that flight sold out within 24 hours. And for folks out there who are still weighing their options, I do just want to point out that the U.S. will not see another eclipse like this for another 20 years. And of course, I had to pick up the hottest accessory in town. I have got my glasses, you guys, so I am ready.
You are ready.
And I did get an extra pair, so if you all are interested in coming down, we can make that happen. But good luck getting a hotel room.
Wow.
Yep. Keep smiling now. Could this April 8th launch us into the real state of emergency? Even martial law, even total chaos in the streets? Could it be? I don't know. You don't know. We don't know what the tyrants have up their proverbial sleeves. So what are we to do to find ourselves prepared and assisting others to get ready? Look at the path it will take from Texas to Maine.
The total eclipse will span a 115-mile wide path across 13 states from Texas to Maine. That's nearly twice as wide as the last major eclipse in 2017, and it will also last twice as long.
How many of you recall where you were in 2017? Preachers, Mr. Producers, do you remember where we were in 2017, that eclipse? We were traveling. We were actually doing a meeting. And that Friday evening, I spoke about the eclipse. I'm not sure what state we were in 2017. We could look it up. Where were you in 2017 for that eclipse? Put that location right there in the chat, and we will feast in the comment section shortly. Now, friends, here it is. Let's remove from the fanfare the excitement and talk about the warnings that are now being sounded. They're telling us cities have already begun to declare a state of emergency due to the influx of people. And they're telling us the solar eclipse tourists will put a strain on the city's resources. When I play this clip, I'm going to ask you a question. Watch.
Bell County, Texas, already declaring a state of emergency because its population of nearly 400,000 could double, maybe even triple.
Everything from our first responders to our healthcare systems, to our fueling stations, to our highways, to our emergency management stations, and more. All of these could be severely strained by the influx of people.
Still.
Do you know what I thought about? I'll ask you a question. What about the thousands, tens of thousands of illegal entry into America from that same southern state, Texas? Remember, it's from Texas all the way to Maine. And they're saying state of emergency due to the influx of people. Even the so-called liberals on the left are willing to say, yes, state of emergency. But they're silent as it relates to the illegal entry of so-called migrants. Do you see my point? Do you hear hypocrisy? Hypocrisy? Now watch this. They talk about local government officials pleading with residents to stay home on April 8th. Watch the eclipse from your house. There it is. Significant problem expected immediately after the eclipse. The list of local communities asking residents to stay home during the upcoming total solar eclipse is growing. It will be crazy, especially after the event is over. Watch this.
As we get closer to April 8th, more and more communities are releasing information for residents to prepare for the solar eclipse.
And as Neil Fisher reports, the Elyria Township Fire Department is the latest to ask residents to watch from the comfort of their own home.
Stay home. Here it is.
Last week, we reported on Summit County's preparations for April 8th.
If you are a Summit County resident, we are encouraging folks to enjoy it from your home.
The Elyria Township Fire Department asks the same of their residents. Stay home for the solar eclipse. But for
stay home. Also, schools in these various states and cities are planning to be closed. The majority of them. Here it is. Michiana schools closing for total solar eclipse. Listen, even in Indiana.
Hey, many central Indiana schools will be closed on the Monday of the total solar eclipse. Some districts include Center Grove, IPS, Carmel Clay schools, just to name a few, and many more will be on e-learning days. Now, we have a full list that we are updating as more schools plan to announce right now at our website at WTHR.com.
State of emergency. Not only in Indiana, it states these Kentucky schools will be closed for the 2024 total solar eclipse. And we have fire department chiefs, local government officials stating, we will do our best to provide safety and to provide services. We'll do our best. In this crisis that they are stating is coming, do you really believe the local government is properly staffed to address all these anticipated crises? Let me tell you something. It's every man for himself. Watch this.
But for the Elyria Township Fire Department and Captain Thomas Elliott, safety is the priority as they welcome thousands of visitors. Captain Elliott tells me they plan on increasing their staff for the solar eclipse by 500%.
500%. Clip two.
Elyria Township Fire Department asks residents to prepare now, including picking up prescriptions, going to the grocery store, and getting proper eye protection.
We're not trying to, you know, scare anybody or anything with that, with us putting out that posting, but it's more just be prepared.
The Elyria Township Fire Department says they will do everything they can to keep the residents and visitors safe, as well as assist.
We're not trying to scare people, nor am I a fear monger. Simply what we're stating, as they said, just prepare, because we never know what can transpire. In other words, we are hearing and seeing what can be and what might be. So what is God saying? Prepare just in case. Imagine if there are crises simultaneously. Who are you going to call? How would they be able to provide services to all these people who are spread out in different cities, counties? It is impossible. Now watch this. Watch carefully. Do you remember Leave the World Behind? That movie we all say is laced with predictive programming theories. There it is. Leave the World Behind. What happened there? Watch this. I'm going to share with you the context.
We are seeing ongoing cyber attacks across the country.
You might say, Pastor, I don't see the connection. A total solar eclipse and a cyber attack? Just hold on. Stay tuned. Because they will tell us the coming April 8th total solar eclipse might lead to cell phone disruptions, internet disruption. Watch this. Move on now. Deep down, we knew this day was coming, but we were found unprepared. Leave the World Behind.
Be over in a couple of hours.
We all knew. Deep down, we all knew. Knew what? Watch. This day was coming. So why were you unprepared?
I'm sure this will turn out to be a big nothing.
We're told in volume 9, page 28, we knew, Bluebirds, we knew the judgments were coming upon the earth, but we did not know that they would come so soon. Others began to say with agonizing voices, you knew? Why then did you not tell us? We did not know. On every side, imagine what's coming. Let me continue. We'll leave the world behind.
Haven't you been picking up on what's going on out there? We've all been deserted.
That's the nail in a sure place. In a national crisis. Don't you realize what's going on out there? We have all been deserted. 911? Hello? 911? You can dial 911 over and over again until your fingertip soars, gets sore, and callus begins to grow. Your finger gets numbed and fall off. Nobody's coming for you. So what's my point? Get ready. It's very simple. Continue. Leave the world behind.
We're in this together until things get back to normal.
Until what? Things get back to normal one day. Lest people miss what I'm saying. April 8th, I'm not saying the world shuts down. I'm not saying that. They're telling us a crisis might ensue. Just get ready in case. My point is, am I prepared right now? Because we know one day it's coming. And many people have seen crises predicted and have come and have passed and things have gotten, well, we have gone back to business as usual. I'm not going to say things have gotten better. Things have gotten worse. Right, continue.
There is no going back to normal.
All right. And what is the end goal based on Leave the World Behind? The globalists like Obama and the other politicians, Klaus Schwab, WHO, UN General Secretary, the Pope of Rome, the Black Pope, the Jesuits. Civil war is the end goal. And look at the first stage. Disruption. That's it. Disisolation. Disable their communication and transportation. Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, are they not telling us this coming eclipse may do just that? Oh, I haven't gotten to the nitty-gritty as yet. Okay. Then stage two. See the point now? You don't know who are the orchestrators. And then people turn on themselves. You mean turn on themselves? You mean cannibalism? Everybody put that word down. Cannibalism. Turn on themselves is not only getting guns and shooting down people you think are the problem. What about eating each other? You wait. Not cannibalism. I'll come to it. Continue. What are they telling us now? Here it is. February 22nd. Counties are declaring state of emergency, headline, ahead of solar eclipse. Let's read a few lines here. The county expects traffic congestion, what else? Fuel shortages and strains on first responders and what else? Medical supply, medical services shortage and food shortage. That's what it says. Listen. And what happened in Leave the World Behind? You see that right there, friends? Only one family had stored up. And the other two families were caught unprepared. Even though one of the two families who was caught unprepared, he said he had been briefed that this might be a reality. Was he prepared? Unprepared. Do you see my point? All right, there it is. That's the guy on the right who was briefed and yet was caught unprepared. No Venmo, no Apple Pay, no PayPal, no digital transactions. All right. Store up. That's what it says. Store up. Stock up. Look at this carefully, my friends. I'm going to move right into a poll question here. Very, very important. Did I catch you by surprise? Note this first question for this poll. Very, very important. And we roll out poll questions to emphasize a particular point. Not for fanfare and gimmick. And so things look trivial. Question number one. Grocery stores generally run on how many days of inventory? One more time. Grocery stores generally run on how many days of inventory? You know what? I'll give you four options. Option A, 1 day. Option B, 3 days. Option C, 21 days. Option D, 30 days. I'll give you 30 seconds to choose prayerfully your answer and put that answer not in the comment section, but in the poll question section. And once the preacher or producer has given a thumbs up, I know it has been posted. It has been. Okay? 1 day, 3 days, 21 days, 30 days. It's coming. Two families in the movie caught unprepared. One family was prepared with medical supplies. For us, that represents natural remedies. Stored up food. Get ready, my friends. It's not a joke. And God is sending us these signs over and over again to say, my people, get ready. You know what? End the poll. Let's get the results here. That was 30 seconds. What do we have for the results? So we have 49%. And that's why I asked this question. 49% chose option B. Only 3 days. That answer is correct. Grocery stores generally run on 3 days of inventory. Let's confirm that. There it is. Headline. How much food does a grocery store really hold? 3 day inventory. Think of it this way. When you go to the store, you pick up things that you currently need and not what you might need months down the road. Stores run on this theory as well. They don't have a massive stockpile of food in the back for the just in case. No, they keep their inventory to a three-day supply. And that was written in 2023. I'll give you a second witness. Don't count on 3 days of food at your grocery store for an emergency. American retail and manufacturers work on the just-in-time theory. The just-in-time theory of supply. All right, friends. Grocery stores use this same premise. They don't stockpile vast amounts of foodstuff in the back. No, they work on a three-day inventory. With that in mind, let me go to my second poll question. FEMA recommends how many days of food and water supplies for each household for a national crisis? FEMA recommends how many days of food and water supplies for each household just in case of a national state crisis? You have four options. Option A, 1 day. Option B, 3 days. Option C, 21 days. Option D, 30 days. I'll give you 30 seconds to prayerfully choose your answer. Again, put the answer in the poll question comment section, not in the regular comment section. Friends, again, these Q&A sessions in the midst of this presentation is to emphasize, to make sure the points stand out in bold relief. All right. 30 seconds have passed based on my clock. Preacher, producer, in the poll. Let's get the results here, friends. So we have 37% chose option B, 3 days supply, said FEMA. That is correct. Allow me to confirm that. There it is. Food and water in an emergency. That's FEMA's website. Look at the right column. The following should be included in your basic disaster supplies kit. The first two bullet points. Number one, 3 day supply of non-perishable food and manual can opener. Second, 3 day supply of water. 1 gallon of water per person per day. You can read the rest of that. Okay, let me get to my third poll question to emphasize and to drive home these points. All right. My friends, next question. Let me get this. Approximately how many days do gas stations have fuel before they need to refuel? To call in the trucks? BP, Shell. What's the other one called, preachers? Racetrack. What else? What? You're from Jamaica, brother? Texaco, he said. Citgo. You're not from Jamaica. Wah-wah. Okay, you have four options. Option A, 5 days. Option B, 2 weeks. Option C, 1 week. Option D, 2 days. You have 30 seconds, friends. 30 seconds. Approximately, how many days do gas stations have fuel before they need a refueling, calling in the trucks, reorder? 5 days, 2 weeks, 1 week, 2 days. 30 seconds, friends. That's what they're saying. The total eclipse of April 8th, influx of solar eclipse tourists from Texas to Maine will put a strain on food and fuel, medical services. I'll get to internet shortly and cell phone. Okay, end the poll, preacher. 30 seconds have passed based on my clock. Let's see what we have. So 41% chose option A, 5 days. Is that correct, Mr. Producer? So based on the research, the option is D. 25% chose option D, 2 days. Look it up. 2 days approximately, not 5 days. And you know that. Have you ever seen those long lines, long queue? Okay, last question. And then I'm going to move on from this. Very, very important now. Based on the Bible, let's go. How many days did Joseph instruct Pharaoh in Egypt to store up for the crisis of famine? How many days did Joseph instruct Pharaoh in Egypt to store up for the crisis of famine? Based on the Bible, you have four options. Option A, 14 years. Option B, 3 years. Option C, 10 years. Option D, 7 years. You have 30 seconds. The clock has begun. All right. I wonder if God, friends, I woke up this morning in prayer with this on my mind, not knowing where God would take us for this midday power surge. And I saw how God connected the dots. Watch what I'm about to say right now. Okay? The clock is ticking. Put that answer in the poll question section. When we come to midday power surge, it's all about spiritual, physical, mental, social, financial preparation. End the poll, preacher producers. Let's get it right now. What do we have? So we have, all right, we have 86% chose option D, 7 years. That answer is correct. Write down Genesis chapter 41 and Genesis chapter 47. That is correct. Allow me to move on now, friends. Are we together? Look at this. Now, hold on. When I remembered 7 years preparation, store up for 7 years, for the 7 years of famine, I wonder if God is saying, just as in the Bible, one day represents 1 year prophetically, and we see 7 years of preparation, could God be saying to us, we need to have at least 7 days preparation of food, water, and supplies in our homes until we can completely be independent of the government? At that point, days, weeks, months won't matter because we are self-sufficient, God-dependent. 7 days supply, at least. And when that came to my mind, look at this article here. FEMA recommends a 3 days supply of food and water, though local authorities in many areas are beginning to recommend at least how many days, my friends? 7 days of food and water. That's it. Look at the reality. Whenever we witness in the city a great crisis, like a monstrous storm, what happens? People begin to run to the local stores, right? To stock up, right? For the worst case scenario, right? What happens now? It leads to serious grocery store shortages. If this lasts any time, then we'll see inflation. That's it. Then we shall see inflation. Am I ready? Are you ready? Roads can get blocked, which means that maybe trucks will arrive and maybe they will not come to the stores. Yes, it's a reality. There's no restocking. Residents are now in a panic. See my point? Red words. Let's reiterate this fact. Food will be scarce within hours, not weeks, not days, hours. All right. Don't rely on the hope that your local stores will be able to supply you with food and water in the event of a crisis. Last sentence, blue words. Treat your own home as your very own store. Do I hear an amen? My friends, the April 8th eclipse is a little more than a month away. But Hill country leaders want residents to get ready when? When? A month before. In a nutshell, have 2 weeks worth of groceries purchased in advance by April 1st. Stop it right there, friends. Of course, I know. Merchants will use this so-called crisis so they can sell more goods. I know that. But do you think that this cannot cause a crisis? Let's wake up. All right, let's continue here. Get these things just in case. Watch this. Listen.
Preppers call this the SHTF scenario, the proverbial S hitting the fan, a breakdown of social norms. John Ramey says, don't panic, just get prepping.
If you have 2 weeks worth of food and water in your home, a radio, some basic supplies, that alone, that little bit of effort and cost covers you for the vast majority of scenarios. That's that minimum threshold that everyone should aspire to.
As more Americans stock up, racing for...
Friends, 2 weeks. Different sources say 2 weeks. Listen attentively. In Genesis 41 and 47, 7 years of plenty, 7 years of famine. One day points to a year in prophecy. Let's downgrade. 7 days, 7 days. That's 2 weeks. The minimum threshold. Dynamiter. 123 in the chat writes, people have to realize that restaurants will be closed. So you need food in your cupboard, in your pantry. Thank you for your comment. That is correct. All right. Noel's air conditioning writes, if you fail to prepare, then prepare to fail. Let's continue here, my friends. Let's talk about the internet now. No cell phone services. They say April 8th. That's it. This came out yesterday, February 27th, 2024. Yes, the eclipse. Experts suggest that people should stock up on 3 days' worth of food, fuel, and water, as the increased population could also put a strain on what? Listen attentively. On grocery stores, gas stations, and what now? Cell phone services. Wait a minute. What happened last week? Last week, Wednesday night into Thursday morning. Have you forgotten? Allow me to remind you.
Good morning, Dave. Yeah, if you are waking up without cell phone signal, you are by far not the only person. When I woke up this morning, I woke up to see the little SOS signal.
All right. Are they preparing us for something coming?
People say that they are unable to send text messages, make phone calls, or even use internet services on their phones. Now,
imagine a crisis in the path of this solar eclipse. Chaos. They can't communicate. I'm not saying this will do it, but it could. Get ready.
AT&T, they write, if you are an AT&T customer and cannot get through to 911, then please try calling from a landline. If that is not an option, then please get a hold of a friend or family member who is a customer of a different carrier and ask them to call 911 on your behalf. Now,
friends, and what happened there? Look at the date on the screen. February 22nd, 2024. Last week, what happened? Pharmacies were having problems and trouble processing some prescriptions because of the internet outage. Right there again. It's a reality. Michael in the chat writes, based on Proverbs 30 and verse 27, the ants are a people not strong, yet they prepare their meat just in case of a crisis. And summertime, summer in the Bible, represents the close of probation. Klaus Schwab.
We all know, but still pay insufficient attention to the frightening scenario of a comprehensive cyber attack, which would bring to a complete halt to the power supply, transportation, hospital services, our society as a whole.
Stop, friends, and that's the point I'm making. Remember, one of their mantras is never let a good crisis go to waste. And they want to surprise us. Watch this. Do you remember earlier I asked you to note the word cannibalism? Watch this. Solar eclipse will come suddenly. And it says, animal behavior in animals will shift rapidly.
During a total solar eclipse, it is almost like day becomes night very quickly.
So knowing that there's going to be a change in that light and life-giving energy means that we can predict when animals are going to have a rapid shift in their behavior.
What? So what may happen? Animals, what may happen? Friends, look at the statement here. It stated in the 1930s, 1940s, when there was a food shortage, up to 1,000 citizens starved to death every day for 3 years. Bodies were discarded in the street. Reports of cannibalism became a problem less than 12 months into the ordeal. Survivors ate anything they could get their hands on, such as birds and rats and family pets. However, all those animals soon became hard to find. This led to gangs being formed that attacked and ate people. It became such a problem that the police force created an quote-unquote anti-cannibal task force. Hold on. And before you say that didn't happen, the history is right there on the screen. Look at it and go find the report. And secondly, it happened in Bible times. The destruction of Jerusalem in the time of King Solomon's temple. And in AD 70, the destruction of Jerusalem. Look at Lamentations chapter 4 quickly. Lamentations. Because some folks might think this is a joke. Lamentations. What a name. Lamenting. Chapter 4 of Lamentations, and consider verse 10. The hands of the pitiful woman have sodden their own children. They were their meat in the destruction. That's cannibalism. And now 60 Minutes ran this report. In a famine, food shortage is 3 days to animal. Watch.
The current estimates from the government is that it would take 2 years to rebuild the grid.
2 years? The Wi-Fi goes down for 5 minutes and everybody panics.
Exactly. And preppers say that it's 72 hours to animal.
Meaning what?
Meaning that it takes about 3 days for people to totally lose it.
I have so much more to share. I'm going to stop it right here. Beloved, the solar eclipse is a sign in the skies, right?
During a total solar eclipse, it is almost like day becomes night very quickly.
Very what? Quickly. Do not be caught by the element of surprise. Christians should be preparing for what is soon to break upon this world as an overwhelming surprise. If you fail to plan, you're planning to fail. So what do we need to do? Rapid movements at the critical moment often disarm the enemy. Why? He's disappointed, vanquished. He expected time to lay his plans and to work his trickeries of deception. Matthew 16, verse 3. Luke 12, verse 54 through verse 56. Oh, you hypocrites. You can discern the signs in the sky. It's going to be foul weather. It's going to rain today. Sunny skies today. Eclipse coming. April 8th. Can you not discern the signs of the times? and the work of preparation. With that in mind, I'm going to land the proverbial plane. Beloved, a storm is coming. Let's be found prepared. Send in a comment. Let me get that. Send in a comment that stood out to you below in the comment section. I'll meet you in the comment section. Give this video a thumbs up. We are streaming on other platforms, X, Rumble, Facebook. It's all there. The links are in the description. As Mastiff writes, people freak out on Black Friday. What makes us think they won't freak out when there's no food? If you want to know who is a Christian, wait until somebody's hungry. When somebody is hungry, you know who is a Christian by how they act when they're hungry. Behavior changes. They'll eat you alive, proverbially and physically. Friends, the Lord is soon to come. There's hope in Christ, Psalm 91. Let us continue the protest. God bless.